Welcome back to Farming Simulator 2015 with the Rude Man, and we're back in Sherwood, and we're harvesting. Seems like we're always harvesting, but let's take a look at where we're at. We got field number one is being done by this guy, and the corn is being collected in whatever field this is. This is field number two. And I don't know what the hell he's doing. What is he doing? Okay, this is field number four. This is our big one. He's doing the first third. If you remember, I split this into three pieces, this field. So I don't know why he's not moving. Let's find out. Got a big square patch missing in the middle there. Don't know what that's all about. Every once in a while, these guys will stop, and you have to put them in cruise control. I had to hit the 3 key to make him move. I don't know what that's about. Also, we were selling corn, trying to get a little bit of money put ahead so we can buy more fields and do more farming. So he's selling corn. He's a little bit slow, but he'll get the job done. And he's going to the Midland. Midland Bulk. That's where he's selling the corn. All right, so we're just kind of waiting for things to happen here. I'm not sure how these guys... Yeah, this field kind of got broken up a little bit. It looks like we're picking up some corn over here. Now this field is pretty good size. It looks like he's working pretty hard on it though. Man, you loaded up the front of that trailer, didn't you? Okay, and this field is humongous. So we're just kind of waiting for everybody to get caught up, and then we're gonna double up on some of these. I'll take this one and maybe kick it over to field number four when he's done. Matter of fact, I'm thinking of just continuing this myself. It's almost done, and I got nothing else to do right at the moment. So we'll do a little manual labor here. Look at that fluffy windrow. I love that fluffy windrow. It's not in all maps, but it's in this one. Yes, somebody asked me about fluffy windrow because they had the mod, the windrow mod, and they didn't see, it didn't look like this. Just having the mod isn't all you need. You need to have the map prepared for the fluffy windrow, and then you can use the mod. It takes both. So if the map isn't prepared for fluffy windrow, you're not going to get it, even though you have the windrow mod. And I can't remember what the windrow mod's called. It's not called that. Those little things that you're not aware of. I came on it by accident. I didn't go looking for this mod. I happened to have downloaded a map that had it on it. And I wasn't aware how it worked. I just knew that the map had fluffy windrow. And I started throwing the mod on all my maps and not paying attention, because I thought it was the mod that did the trick. And it wasn't until somebody pointed out to me one time, well, how come this farm doesn't have fluffy windrow? And I said, oh, you're right. It isn't fluffy. Well, I have the mod on. And that's when I started doing a little research. Found out that the map has to be prepared for it. Well, it's kind of like everything else. It's kind of like the soil mod. I've got the soil mod. You can throw it in your mod folder, but if the map isn't prepared for it, it's not going to function. Now, I don't think I have a wind drawer, but I can't remember. I might have. I'll go check the yard here in a minute. I know I've got an extra tractor that's not being used. And it's another bright, sunny day on the farm. Isn't that beautiful? I tell you, I think winter's going to come on early where I live. We didn't have a real warm summer. And it's starting to get, even now... Normally, we usually have warmer weather in, you know, in August and first of September, but it's been kind of chilly for summer where I live. That's why I'm thinking it might be an early winter. It's already getting down to 40 Fahrenheit at night, and it's barely getting 68 during the daytime. But we've had very few days over 70 all summer. And I know I mentioned that to somebody that lived in Texas, and they took offense. You're upset because it's cool summer? I'd like to live in 114 degree weather. Well, no, thank you. Well, I love Texas, but I don't know if I could live there. I suppose you'd acclimate, wouldn't you? I know you would, because I moved from... I grew up in the Yakima Valley, and it's 100, 110 all summer long. Well, it used to be. I don't know what it is now. But, because I haven't been there for 30-some years. But we were used to it. We didn't think too much of it. Of course, when you're young, you can handle it a little better. At least that's my opinion, and I'm sticking to it. But you acclimate to things. I kind of like cooler weather better in one respect. You can put more clothes on if you get cold. But if you live in a warm climate and you take all your clothes off and it's still 114 degrees, ain't nothing you can do about it unless you buy yourself an ice bucket, sit in it. All right, this is whipping this one up. Now, we're going to move up to field number 4, and I'm pretty sure that I'm going to need to undo this header to do that. So, let me do that. We'll grab this and then we'll put that grain in the truck over there. And then we'll hit the road, Jack, and not come back. No mo, no mo, no mo, no mo. Alright, what's the deal here? There we go. Oh, is it going to fill that thing up? It did fill it up. Gracious. Alright. We're going to have to go empty this before we can move this combine. Open, 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 open. There we go. Now, looking for... Well, I didn't see a wind drawer. I can't remember if I have one or not. I'll have to look. Look and see if I've got a wind drawer. I just don't recall. Well, I got that thing. It's not very big. So I do have one. It's not the big one. Yeah, I don't see the big one. That might have to do. Should get the bigger one, though. Some of those fields are pretty good size. I mean, I have a little bit of money. I got almost $3 million. I can start purchasing some things. All right, I'm going to go back out and... How do I come in that way? Whoa, that was close to filling that thing again. All right, let's get this thing motating. And we're heading up this way, field number 4. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Any day. Come on, open up. And let's see, how do we get out of this over here, I think. There we go. Now, let's see, I split this up into 3 pieces. So, how am I gonna do this one? I think, maybe, right here. Let's hook up our header. Put the wheels away. All right, so I think what I'll do is just come across here manually right here and split this field up just like I did on the other side. That's funny, comes out of the combine dark and makes nice white fluffy straw. Pretty amazing how that works. I wonder why it kicks it off to the left a little bit. Never noticed that before. All right, got a lot of soybeans going here. Now, I'm going to do the same thing I did on the other side. I'm going to make 2 passes. And the reason I do that is sometimes I've seen, not course play, but I've seen auto combine jump across a gap. So I don't want it to jump across to that other side of the field, so... So I'm going to do 2 passes. And I better go check on those other 2 combines. These city zombies hired help. They don't, they're not very intuitive. They're not self-starters, I would say. Yeah, they pretty much have to be told what to do. All right, let me see how this is going to work. If I start here. I don't know. Let's see. See what he's gonna do. Well, he's gonna follow the contours of the field well enough, I guess. So, I guess I'll just let it go. Don't get too high up on that hill, you'll get stuck. Yeah, look what you're doing. I'm not driving. This is a hired help. Straighten yourself out. All right, let's go check. He's not done. He just cut himself off from part of the field. Well, I thought this guy's going to need some help. But he's actually done pretty well for himself. Now that's kind of odd. I thought I was selling corn. Well, I am selling corn, but it doesn't seem to be making me any money. Of course, it takes him an hour to get back and forth from the farm because of that route that I created. Squirrely route. The long haul is what it is. Uh-oh, I missed a stalk or two. What am I going to do? No, no. Say it ain't so. All right. Where's the rest of it? There it is. How much is there? Right, there's enough there that I think I'm gonna... Whoa! Look what you done! Alright, I'm gonna let him take over here. And we'll go check on everybody else. What is the deal here? Is he... Oh, he's done with this side of the field, so... Now we'll jump up to, we should have that, just that big long piece at the top up here left. Let's see how this is gonna work. Whoa! I got my foot stuck on the gas pedal, or the brake pedal. All right, let's see. I'm gonna start this manually, and then once we get up here, we'll hire somebody and let them go. All right, we're over 28 now. Okay, let's see about getting a tractor. What do we got that's not being used? That little booger, but he don't do... Oh, I got this guy. Look at that grain. Okay. This is rye. Want some rye? Of course you do. From a classic game, Return to Zork. I love that game. Want some ride? Of course you do. I wish you could see the grain come out of those things. Those little slidey drawer things work, don't they? I never noticed that before. Oh, look at that. That's cool. All right, well, so much for that. Now, do I need this thing out in the field? I don't think I do. So let's see what else we've got here. Is that our truck coming in? It is. Now he's not selling the corn. Wait a minute, no wonder. Oh, no. That's not the selling corn guy. That's the bringing corn in guy. All right, gotcha. Okay, I'll buy that for a dollar. Oh, wait a minute, what's he doing? Oh, this guy's, okay. He's doing his thing. Trick is he going to see that one on the left there? Is he going to see that combine down that way because of this ridge here? He may try to go across that ridge to reach that combine and get stuck. So let's see. I was going to look at this. We're down to corn and... No, wait a minute. We just did rye. Where's it at? There's the rye. We don't have much in soybeans yet. But we do have rye. Let's sell that rye. So rye is being sold where? Let's see. Okay, where's the rye? Right there. All right. Okay, at the grain dryer, 1264, 1302 at Midland Bulk. So let's do that. We're going to do the Midland Bulk thing. So, no course loaded. We're going to do grain to Midland. Right there. And go back. Select this right here. And make sure that we do rye. I didn't see it. Everything but rye. There it is. Okay. Let's see how this is going to do. Where's our... Uh-oh. That's not going to work very good. Let's see. Let's get this guy out of the way. Oh, no. You're going the wrong way. Don't go that way. Go this way. Right, he might need a little bit of four-wheel drive. Let's give him that. Start him up again. Oh, shoot. That messed him up, didn't it? All right, let's get this guy and make sure he's got four-wheel drive just a little bit. All right, how's Corn Guy doing? All right, so we're selling rye and corn. Let's go check on the combines. Oh, see, I told you that guy was going to get stuck, didn't I? I don't know what he was trying to do, but you're pretty much full. What are you trying to do? I think he was trying to turn around and go back to his point, his starting point, but he was too close to that berm and got stuck. That's my thought. What is he doing? What? Why is he not working? I don't understand. Why are you not working? Well, there he goes. That was weird. It's like he was stuck on a stump or something. That was strange. Yeah, he's coming down to an end. Uh-oh. Trouble. What the hell is going on here? Alright, let's stop him. Get him out of the way. He's kind of confused here anyway. You really need to be going down this road here. Alright, so let's see. We were going to do a windrower. Let's buy one of these. And then let's have it mailed to the farm. What? What? That's the one I wanted. Rot butter. Reset the tool. There you go. What do we have up here? A tractor and a trailer. Why do I have a tractor and a trailer up there? That's odd. All right, we need that tractor right there. And we're going to put him to work. Picking up some straw. Alright, so let's see, we were going to what? We need to go to this field. I'm lost. This one? No. Oh my god. Oh, that windrower got caught in the gate. Isn't that weird? Out there is weird. I don't care who you are. All right, now this is a weird field. I don't know quite how to do this. So, did we do it before? That's my question. Let's see, straw. And if we did, how did it work? Yeah, we did. But how did it work? It started, where? It started over here. No, not over here. Well, it looked like it did. Oh, it did. I drove right by it. I wonder if it was the smaller windrower, though. I bet it was. bet it was. Let's take a look, though. Yeah, that doesn't look like that big wind drawer, does it? All right, let me try something here. I'm going to try to adjust this and see if it works. Never done this before. Oh, geez, we got a truck and a tractor caught. Right, let's see what this is. Let's see if this will work. I don't know. I've never done it this way before. Well, not going to work that way. I don't think it will. I really don't. All right, let's go find who's stuck in traffic here. Same two guys. Well, let's get out of that and get into the tractor. He's got an easier time getting out of the way, I think. Give me a break, truck driver. Hell, I thought as long as that route was, they wouldn't meet someplace in the middle, but I was wrong. All right, look out, town zombie, coming through. Oh. He's done. Great demand for grass. Well, too bad, so sad. I don't know if I have any grass. I don't think I do. I don't think I've mowed any grass since I've been on this farm. I don't mind this farm, but it's not my favorite farm to record. All right, let's see what these two guys are doing. Okay, so he's going up and down, up and down. And other guy's just going round, round, round. He's getting pretty close to being done, though. You know what? Let me stop this guy and straighten this out a little bit. This field's kind of awkward looking. I'm just going to go straight across here. Uh-oh, Taurus is slipping. Okay, he fixed himself. It's always good they can take care of themselves. And he's slipping again. Is that the... I'll bet that's probably the windrower, because that windrower gets caught on every damn thing. And I mean everything. Yeah, he's going to play that game through the whole field. You wait. Let me spin around here. I'm just going to take it from that corner right here. yet. Combine's just working up a storm. Doing a harvest. All right, clean this little patch up here. Yeah, that's kind of a mess there too. By the time I'm done fixing this little mess, there ain't gonna be nothing left of the field. Okay, so somebody's empty. It's the Kenworth. So we've sold all the rye, looks like. We'll start him selling soybeans here pretty quick. This field's gonna be done pretty quick. As soon as I'm done with this little patch, I'll put him over on the other side and there won't be anything left. Well, that didn't work very good. I still got a little bit of a jog here. Let's go up and see what that guy's corn guy's done. Well, which one did he said was empty? All right, I'm confused. Did I read that wrong? Okay. He's only got 93%. So he emptied the rye silo and then sat there for a minute and then decided, you know what? 93% is close to being full. I'll go ahead and deliver this. That's what I'm thinking. All right. Is this guy was working? It is. That windrower is going to have all kinds of trouble. All right, auto wash is going to take over, and I'm just going to wait. Watch. And we'll take over as soon as we get to the end here. And that's close enough for government work. I'm gonna let this guy take over now from up here. Well, maybe. Okay, I was wrong. I don't know if that guy's ever going to get that field windrowed. Yeah, see, that's the beauty and the beast of this map. It's kind of nice to have a map that doesn't have just square, flat fields. But on the other hand, it's a challenge. All right, let's go catch him. Oh, wait a minute. Is the truck back? This guy's got like 2 grains of corn in it, or kernels, and that's it. But he doesn't want to give up till he drops every last drop. There he goes. Okay, let's go get this guy to drop his load. Activate that. And I'm going to end the episode here. Hope you had fun. If you did, give it a like, share it with a friend, subscribe if you haven't. I'll see you back on Sherwood in the next episode. Happy farming.